Last week, a 7.1 magnitude earthquake hit China, the latest in a string of high-profile quakes that have killed thousands of people this year.
Yeah, it may have you asking, is this recent earthquake activity the sign of bigger things to come? KXLY4's Melissa Leff answers that question in tonight's Good Question.
It seems like all year long, the images of destruction have come to us from around the globe. Just last week, China, a 6.9 magnitude earthquake rattled the country, and the death toll there will continue to rise. The week before that, Indonesia, a massive 7.7 magnitude earthquake, leaving fears of tsunamis in its wake. The week before that, it was Baja, Mexico. A quake there rattled the western United States. And of course, who can forget Haiti, January, when images of destruction and devastation continue to come in and the death toll continues to grow.
The earthquake in Haiti set off a devastating year. The quake killed more than 200,000 people, equivalent to wiping out every person in the city of Spokane. After that, they came like a chain reaction, quake after devastating quake. You have to wonder, is the shaking the sign of things to come?
We ignore them unless, you know, there is some impact on human populations.
Dr. Richard Orndorff chairs the geology department at Eastern Washington University. He watches global activity on this seismograph outside his office.
When the Earth moves...
He's not surprised that we're asking if these quakes signal something's amiss with planet Earth, but he's quick to tell us there's nothing to worry about.
You could not make the argument that we're even at average or that we have a sudden increase in the number of large earthquakes.
Each year, the USGS expects one 8.0 magnitude quake or higher. That came this year in February off the coast of Chile. For earthquakes ranging from 7.0 to 7.9, we can expect 17 a year. So far, we've had five. And earthquakes ranging from 6.0 to 6.9, expect 134 of those every year.
If you look at the fact that we're in the month of April, that we've basically already experienced 33% of the year, we are 13% below our expectation in terms of the large magnitude earthquakes.
Below average, but never entirely out of the woods. Western Washington is considered high risk for seismic activity, experiencing a major quake every 300 to 500 years. The Nisqually quake that shook Seattle in 2001 was almost the same size as the quake that rocked Haiti. In Eastern Washington, the risk is relatively low, but a recently discovered fault line hints at the energy building up under the surface. Have you ever noticed how straight Latah Creek runs? Well, geologists suspect it's an ancient fault that could release seismic energy anytime. Overall, though, just because this has been a devastating year, there's no greater risk globally than any other one.
The reason that there was so much damage and so many fatalities was because of the nature of Haiti, not the nature of the earthquake.
With this Good Question, I'm Melissa Luck, KXLY 4 HD News.
We'd like to hear your good questions. No subject is off limits, so just send the question about the world, how it works, to goodquestion@kxly.com.